بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اسمحوا لي في البداية ان انا اطلب من حضراتكم جميعا ان احنا نقف دقيقة احداد على ارواح شهدائنا كلهم وشهداء الشرطة.
One moment to express our mourning for the dead police officers. Indeed.
أنا جيت النهاردة
today
عشان
I came to police academy to spend few hours with our great heroes in police academy, and indeed it gave me much pleasure to hold such a dialogue with our students at the academy. I was very relaxed and pleased to have this kind of dialogue with them. I'm saying this because the Police Academy used to play an eminent role in the history of Egypt. We can fully remember the police performance since a very long time ago. We can fully remember on January 25 when First Lieutenant Mustafa refused to belittle his own country, his own state. Even the price was his own life. And indeed, the message we are trying to deliver here, that you are playing an eminent role to save this country, and you are doing this in a very difficult time indeed in the history of Egypt, indeed to provide peace, safety and security for the citizens is not an easy job at all. Egyptians should never be intimidated here in Egypt, and indeed it's because of you, because of what you are doing for this country and for the people of this state. I'm saying this so as to enforce the slogan we launched. We said that the army, police and the people are unified together. This is not just a slogan, these are not just words. We are giving this slogan so as to live it. We need to persist on going on and to survive and to do it together. We all should come together and be one hand. We should all be unified, and we need to keep this unity. I'm saying this at the very beginning of my speech. Because we don't want individual practices to separate us. Let us be objective. When we say that we would like to support sovereignty of law, this is not an easy thing to do. It's a very difficult thing, even for us. And I'd like to talk about police officers here. You have the full right to feel loyal to your own academy and to feel loyal to the security apparatus. But you should be fair enough, and you should do this with impartiality. You should never be biased to any of the entities. Why I'm saying this? Because when we hear about individual practices, we shouldn't consider all of the practices to be violations of the law. We need to keep and to save the value of your duty, what you are presenting or providing to this country. You are providing a valuable service for this country. Do you know what does it mean that Egyptians are feeling safe in the street? Do you know what does it mean that to have an Egyptian lady going on the street feeling safe? This is your responsibility. Maybe people haven't seen this before the last 5 years. Maybe people can't easily notice. what you were doing. But indeed, after the experience we have gone through in the last 5 years, it became crystal clear that we are all in a dire need for each other, and we need all to care about each other. That's why I'm saying that you need to focus upon this. We all should stay unified. We should all stay together. And leaders of the security apparatus should give the example and the model for other officers. We need all to take this into consideration. We need all to focus upon this. You should all notice that we should never accuse the whole apparatus because of some of the individual practice. How many police stations or police points do we have? 300 nationwide? Okay. So if we say that the violation may occur in one police station or even two, although we fully reject those violations, however, we can say that violations are spread all over the 300 police stations. However, this is not the message I'm trying to deliver here. I'm here to tell you that we all fully remember our martyrs in Rafah, Al Arish. They are still alive in our heart, and we still remember them. We didn't forget them yet. And this is your duty to sacrifice your life for this nation, for the safety and security of the people of Egypt. So I'm here to express deep thanks and appreciation for the effort exerted in the parliamentary elections. You've been able to fully secure the whole process and to be completely impartial while you are holding this responsibility. And the public opinion as well as different entities are following your impartiality and you're following your integrity in securing the polling station nationwide. You have been securing the parliamentary elections and allowing voters to vote in a completely secure atmosphere. I hope that through your strenuous effort, we may be able to support and enhance safety and security in Egypt. And I hope you can do it 24 hours a day. All of the Egyptians should feel safe and secure on their lands. And indeed, I fully support the police officers to fully recognize that they are dealing with their own brothers. While talking to the students at the police academy, I found that they fully realize the situation we are going through. They are saying that we lie under great pressure, and that kind of pressure at some time may be very difficult. And I can fully understand that kind of pressure you are working under, because indeed the kind of effort required to be exerted is so much, and it's very difficult to control the situation. It's not an easy thing, of course, to combat terrorism. And I fully recognize that a lot of effort is required nationwide and that you are doing your best. I know it's a big pressure practiced over you. However, I'm pretty sure that you can do it. You can do it and you can bear and you can go through that kind of pressure. You can even bear more and more pressure. Assure me, please, that you can do it. Yeah. You are the best people to save and secure Egypt. It's your responsibility. You, along with the Egyptian army, it's your responsibility to save and to protect Egypt. Safety, stability, and security of this country and of this people is your own responsibility. All of the attempts to attack our safety and security will never succeed. I'm sure that you can do this, and You will be presenting the best model for the Egyptian citizens in your own treatment with Egyptian citizens at different police stations. Let me give this small remark. Indeed, all of those several attempts to break the kind of unity we have formed throughout the last 2 or 3 years will never come to an end. And you should take this into consideration. There are several attempts to break the kind of unity we are having here in our country. They are trying to break the kind of unity we are having in between the police, the army and the people. There will be lies, will be accusations, and there will be conspiracies even against that kind of unity. So I hope we can come together, we can support each other more for the best of our country, for the best of our nation. I hope we can do our best, and I hope we can have some kind of a self-denial for the best of our country, for the best of our nation. And the people fully recognize what you are doing, and they fully recognize the kind of responsibility you are bearing. You all should bear in mind that safety and security of this country is your own responsibility. We need all to be loyal to this mission, and we should try to fulfill it. As long as we are sticking to such values, and as long as we adhere to such principles, we'll be able to achieve success. That's the promise of Allah the Almighty, that as long as we adhere to our principles, and as long as we are abiding by our values, we'll be able to achieve success. This is the promise of Allah the Almighty, and as long as you are keeping the pledge, we'll be able to do it. So again, I'm repeating that this is your own responsibility. It's laid on your own burden. So safety and security of the Egyptians, safety, security and stability of Egypt, and maybe safety and security of the whole region is your own responsibility. Because if anything goes wrong with our country, the whole region will fail. And I'm saying this to whether I come to meet with. I'm trying to tell them all that Egypt is the cornerstone of this region. And unless we are capable of saving and protecting our country, we'll never be able to survive as a region. So case will spread all over the region. If anything wrong goes with Egypt, I don't want to be lengthy. And of course, I will come and visit you every day at 5 a.m. God bless you all, and I wish you all the best. Thank you very much.
السلام الوطني.